Hello everybody again, and welcome back. We are just going to pop back into the dock. There's quite a bit of noise in the background. I've upped the volume. We're going to pump up to our bait limit of 1500. We're going to stick with 100 boxes, or 100 whatchacallums, and we'll take on just a little bit more fuel. That'll run $1,000, and
is it okay if we step out? I can't wait
sure.
To go for a walk.
Get shore leave, go for a walk, that's fine. Okay, so we've 130,000 left, and we're going to stick with the crew that we have right now. Everybody seems to be quite happy. Tom is going to get there, I hope, over the course of some time. Buster, I need to have a conversation with and see where he wants to be at, because I'm not really convinced about that. Maybe we're going to take Norman in instead, actually. Let's hire him as a deckhand.
Okay.
There you go. Norman doesn't mess around a bit. We are going to have a quick look at what we're doing. Looks like a lot of the boats are already going out. And we will have a quick look at the survey just to get ahead. And that's going to be the area there. So we're going to set up to about here as well. And we'll fast forward time and get everybody out. And we will stop about there.
Tighten the stack. The weather's going to get rough. You've got to love this job.
Okay, well, outside we've got some fairly significant weather going on. We have 36 hours before the season starts, and awesome. Alright folks, the season is now officially open.
Money, let's go make some money. Fill these empty pockets.
Yes, Tycho. And don't fall off the boat this time. We're going to have hard weather. I'm going to take more care of you. Alright gentlemen, let's get your fishing. First spot is being baited. And everything is going to get ready. And yeah, we are going to hit forward gear, which is what I want there. And we're going to send it. And we are on the rudder, kind of automatic pilot control. And we're going to be setting a run of string maybe along here. I'm just going to tighten that up ever so slightly. Judging by the survey information, we'll be kind of going through a couple of crab territories here. So that's much more of a distance here. Not that much more of a distance, but hopefully enough of a distance here between them now that it's just going to be a generally more relaxed type of setup. We're just running along at a steady speed. So I'll bring you back in a little
bit
later.
Okay, everybody.
Just a quick update here. I've just noticed that Spike has fallen over a couple of times. Norman is also getting tired. Roxanne has made a meal and she's been out rucking. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop this here. Get it unhinged. We're just going to send everybody to go for a meal. So he's going to drop that back and put it away, and then everybody is going to go for a meal and some sleep. And we're going to give everybody a break because we've been working for 7 hours plus the morning, and it's fairly heavy going. And we're just going to hold station here on the boat. And
Norman
is now deciding to sleep. He took a while about going to sleep for some reason. Everybody else is looking good. There are icebergs there. Ooh. That's different. Got a bit of an ice buildup that's going on there as well. A nice ice buildup. But it's nothing that serious just yet. We'll have to do some ice work a little bit later. But for now, we can send another one of those in, basically. Which is good. That means the soak is 13 hours for the first pots. And we are continuing on quite nicely. No icebergs or anything in my arena. Directly ahead, we may have... may have one directly ahead that we need to be aware of. Tycho is doing the bait for us again. This guy just doesn't stop. Had a little bit of a spill in the last trip, which wasn't great. But, he was okay. He's decided to come back this season, and I'm more than happy to have him back. Roxanne is a fixed member of the crew here. Spike is new. He kind of helped us out on the last part of last season. Norman is new, and Tom was back for last season as well. And he seems to be pretty good. Stan, I let go. And Buster... Buster wanted to take a break, which I respect, and we got Norman in instead. Here we are, trying to turn on to our first buoy, which I don't actually think we're going to be able to achieve. We may need to stick her in reverse here and back up quite a bit. Judging by the information, fleet hasn't started to pick up anything yet. And we've been soaking for 31 hours here early on, so that's kind of getting back to half of where we need to be going. We're going to see if we can bring this one over here, which we are doing quite nicely now. Let her sail back. Alrighty then. Good. Let's get ready to start picking up some pots here now, folks. First one is coming up. And we are going to be manually maneuvering ourselves onto here, and we will be making a decision on whether we're going to bring it back with us or what we're going to do. He's fairly tight there, but I hope that he's going to throw and get on it. And he is. Doesn't look too bad immediately. Let's get down here and see what this is saying. Looking full of crap, actually. Alright, we got what? 500, set it back. Cool. That has worked out rather nicely. I think generally... can't complain. I think that was a good start. I wonder will all the pots be as good as that. Here we go. Good, we got it. May need to add a little bit more space between these pots. going forward, just so that we can manage to operate. But here we go. Looks like another fairly decent load in there. Yeah, set it back. That's a bit good. 600s.
Right there.
Yes, it is. Red gold right there. I need you guys to keep nice and basically keep nice and fit. We're enjoying the weather right now. The question is, are we going to be able to enjoy it all the time? So, 503 keepers. We will set that back as well. Everybody's in good form. Everybody's energy is fairly decent. And hopefully, yeah. Hopefully we get some good results. But this is a short stop. Tom is fixing a hose outside. If we pop out, we can see from up here that he's sorting out the hose at the bottom of the crane. The short one, easy fix. And he'll be done in a second, so good job. Well done, Tom. We are getting through this fairly well. There's a few still ahead of us. But it's not doing too bad.
This is an interesting
statistic. We have caught 30,000 pounds. The fleet has caught 37,000 so far. So we are miles ahead of the fleet so far. Interesting.
Here we are coming up on the next buoy. I'm doing most of the driving from the wheelhouse here.
I am the captain of the boat, so we're trying to stick with that principle of working from the wheelhouse as much as possible. I occasionally pop out as far as here to have a look at what's going on. It's kind of suggesting that I'm kind of up on the side or something here. Can't really walk out. It would be nice if you could, I suppose, but then what's the point of that? And the boys are getting good with this. Hundreds. And that's 330, so that's a low one. I'm going to set it back, though. 330 is... we can handle 330. But just look at where we are on the scheme of things. We should be getting into heavier territory. The last was 22 hours ago, and these ones are soaking for 33, so should be in a relatively decent position. Endurance wise, everybody is doing fairly okay. Happiness wise, the older crew are happy, and I'm expecting that Norman and Tom are going to become happier if we carry on with this run. And it appears that we're doing decent enough. Great stuff. Just giving a chance to pull it up and get stuff done. I'm just turning in here a little bit. There's that whale again. I'm just turning in here a little bit with the line so that we're in a decent position. There we go. We have got a number here, and the number is 338. Still decent. We will set it back. Okay, hi again. Just going to set a waypoint here. We have another electrical panel failure, which is a little bit frustrating, because it's, you know, it's something that I thought was fixed, to be honest with you, and it's not. But anyway, we also have icebergs out here. We have a friendly whale that's popping around. Tom is fixing the panel, and the other four are able to get on with working, apart from Roxanne, who for some reason
hasn't gotten any sleep, so...
Nothing better than good fishing. I'm so tired. I'm running on autopilot now.
Captain, you're running on autopilot.
Since you just let someone else take a rest...
Yeah. I treat all my people on their own merits. That's that down. And then it's the last one to get thrown in. And time is going to be finished. No, you were short, but you could have waited for us to get a bit closer. Big one now. Make it happen. Make it happen. That's a short one. Big one. Good man, Tom. Thank you. There you go. That looks like a good one. Good throw. Okay, Roxanne, you just go and prepare a meal, and then you're going to go and rest. And, yeah, that's going to bring in that last one, and hopefully they're able to process this out of there by now. We'll see what this is, and then we'll circle back around and get ourselves set up. Water is getting a little bit more busy. I'm expecting that we're going to have different weather on the next run, but so far so good. Up with it. Looks like it's a full old pot anyway, so set it back, Tom. So we have caught 73,000. The fleet has bumped up to 239,000 all of a sudden, so we're still doing all right. But is only as good as it is. That's just about to go. We're going to get everybody working on ice. And I'm going to set ourselves back for another turnaround.
Right, we have a little bit of weather coming in. It's getting a little bit more wavy here now. All my guys have got fairly good energy, so we're going to try and manage that as we move forward here. But I'm very conscious of the fact that the last time we had people falling over and stuff in this big weather, so we are proceeding with caution this time now. I still want to get the crab in, but as soon as we see anything major going on, I'll be hitting the brake. Set it back. These are looking really good, but big waves going on.
Okay, so welcome back. We did have more rough seas earlier on, and I got everybody inside and got them to rest. Things have calmed down a little bit now, so we are proceeding to pull in some of these pots. The pot we're approaching now has been soaking for 32 hours, and we're getting solid 400s coming up, which is not too bad. It's also a little bit easier to maneuver now that the sea has settled down just a little bit. It's still not calm, but this is pretty okay operating conditions, I think, for everybody on board. Apart from Spike, who seems to be on his ass a lot out there, but doing no injury to himself apart from slipping off his feet, so he must have a pair of glass shoes on or something, because he's got no grip. We are getting the hooks on to the boys without too much difficulty. I'm able to get relatively close. The view outside will show you where I'm aiming for here, and that means that they're able to get in onto them fairly quickly. And we're ticking along up here quite nicely. We still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We're about halfway through the string here at this point in time. in terms of the overall count, we're about a third of the way through at the 71-hour mark. So I'm expecting that we've got another day and a half or 2 days available to us. And here we'll see what we're getting out of the tank here with this load. It's 417. This one's a little bit on the lighter side, but it's still inside. It's still in the 400 mark. Are approaching a little under 50% for the fleet. Looks like we can do around 220,000 pounds of crab if we were to fill our hold full. So enough to see.
Oh man, that's gotta hurt.
No. Who's hurt? Tico is going in to take care of somebody. And we're going to slow down here a little bit. I think Norman has a hernia. There's not much we can do. We'll have to take him to hospital the next time we're in harbor. Phil, it's good out here. Okay, so it doesn't seem that we can get very far without set it back, without having an injury on this boat. Which, it is a dangerous job, I guess, so from that perspective, it probably makes sense. I'm sorry to hear that Norman has had a hernia, though, because that means he's out for a couple of months. That's his season over, and we'll be just nursing him back. Let's go and talk to him. What?
I think I'm out of commission for this season.
Yeah, I think you are, too. Stay safe in there.
Okay, welcome back. We are at the second from last pot. That's the last pot there. Tom has just told us that we've got an electrical problem which needs to be fixed.
Mind if I take a quick nap?
Jesus, Spike. Okay. No, not now. For God's sakes, man. Good kid, but he's a kid. 636 keepers. How about that for a job? We'll put that back.
There's some serious money in there.
And you'll all be getting a bit of a sleep in a little while, just as soon as we get the last one in, so load it up and we will be good. There it goes. And there she be. Last pot, people. Last pot, and then we'll be getting food and some sleep. Just make sure you get it. Unbelievable. When you're that tired, I suppose it's not easy. Get on up there now. Come on, I can't make it any easier for you. There is it. Let me go back a little bit more. This is just ridiculous.
Nothing better than good fishing. Okay.
Go and prepare a meal. Tycho, go and get this for us, will you? Good man, thank you. Maybe Roxanne actually got that before the end. I'm not sure. But in any case, we now have it. And we'll take him out and pack him away. We need to get this crab that's on the table, though. We need to get that back into the water. Otherwise, it'll be dying. Which won't be very good. Okay. 601. Set it back. Here we are. We're stacking as we go along, picking up this last string. We're at 93 hours in the season. The load of the fleet is 820, so I'm expecting that we're going to get a notification probably within the next 12 hours on the clock here that the season will be ending in 24 hours. Getting into water and okay. But Tom seems to be constantly falling over here now. Which is kind of dumbass, to be honest with you. So he's not being very much use. Well, I've just brought everybody in for a bit of a break because they're getting tired and they're falling down all over the place. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, possibly 10 of the boxes to bring in, so I'm thinking it kind of makes sense to just hold position here a little bit, and actually I will just fast forward time a little, and that will give us the auto rudder, which is useful. And we have just the rest of these pots to bring up, so quite a decent amount actually. And these pots have been triggering solid 400s all the time, so that's looking pretty good. In terms of the season, I think there's still some of the season left actually, so we're bringing the pots in now because I think we're going to be fairly full. Mind you, judging by how the season count is here, two-thirds, we're at about 900, there's 200 more to go. I wonder if there's sense in dropping a couple of pots here still. 477, we'll stack that. Might be a couple up here though.
Well, everybody,
we are at 92% here now with three more pots left in. The weather has calmed down quite a bit. Norman has a hernia. Everybody else is holding out fairly well. Spike is getting tired actually. That's the only one issue. But at least the boat is not rolling around the place and he doesn't seem to be falling on his ass quite so much. We're getting solid 500s at the moment still.
I guess this spot's out of crab.
Just... Dude. Look at our tanks. There's only so much we can take and that's kind of pretty much close to that, so put it away. So... what's the latest? Well, basically we have Roxanne there like a trooper, Tom is good, and Tico of course, so I mean these three are keepers. Assuming the weather is decent and nothing else goes wrong, I mean Roxanne has turned out to be one of the better dickheads, period. And she's a girl! Just goes to show you the prejudice doesn't really make any sense. Girls can rock it anywhere they like. It's us guys that have this attitude that the pretty things can't handle it, but tough cookies, they're all tough cookies, they can handle it.
I guess this spot's out of crab.
Spike, look, you're just going to sleep and talking is just not really intelligent. If you're going to say something useful. But as the captain of this boat, and this is me talking to myself here and everybody can hear me, I wouldn't say that to him unless he really pissed me off, and then I'd call him aside one afternoon and say, hey dude, let's just get something straight. Here's how I react when you say things like this. When you have your boat, then you can say things like that. You can react possibly the same as I'm reacting to you now if you hear people saying what you're saying to me to you then. So. Simply put, stop talking. Thank you. Right, now, this is the last one. on this side. And as soon as we get it up, I mean, the season is not even over yet. We haven't got the 24-hour news on it. It's 921, so there's still 200 to go. We're 98.8, and this is going to damn near put us back on direction. So get to about here, and give ourselves some forward motion and turn. Bulls.
I guess this spot's out of crap.
Big one, so that means we're
go big or go home.
We are going to meet our quota. We've got a couple more putts in the water down here that we're just going to take out now, because we don't see any point in leaving them in, to be honest with you.
Thanks for the break, Captain.
Where are those crabs going to fit? Don't you know the tanks are full?
I'm all for extra crab, Captain.
We're full, man.
Yeah, I know, but, like, where the hell are we going to... We can't just leave the tanks here. Or do we just leave them here now?
I'll take care of that.
These breakdowns are really putting a...
Yeah, putting hitch on our giddy up. Dock it. Sell the catch. Here's the money.
Mind
boom.
If we hit ashore? I can get my understand.
Nope. This is a big payday. Look at this number rack up. Now we've got quite a few dead losses though. Jesus, we're looking at...
The season is now officially closed.
Okay.
Season's over. We're done.
Yep. Let's continue. Because we're looking at about 15%, a little bit like 17-18% here. What? How did that happen? I don't understand the mechanics of the game here, because I didn't pick those fish up outside the season. $142,000. $111,000 for the crew share. Don't understand how I actually got that. That deal done. Well, we'll apply. Choppy conditions for king crab is the next one up. But that's it for now. So I'm going to leave that for now. We have 271 here on the repair front. We don't have any repairs to make. Higher crew side, we do need to put someone in here. We'll work on that a little bit later. And upgrades and everything else, we haven't really done anything, so that was a bit of a mistake. We should have maybe done that. But we'll do that next time, and we'll deal with the situation as it is. So until next time, go handy.